South Lake, Texas is a world apart from Detroit City, and this five-bedroom, five-bathroom mansion, the polar opposite of a jail cell. Detroit last saw its former mayor, Kwame Kilpatrick, leaving jail disgraced.
And I apologize immensely.
Surprisingly, as a convicted felon, Kilpatrick headed straight for South Lake.
I did so with the intent to mislead the court and the jury.
Just after pleading guilty to perjury and obstruction of justice.
I'm sure he just had to get somewhere where the heat wasn't on him.
Former prosecutor Toby Shook says he's seen it all before.
Out of sight, out of mind.
In South Lake, Kilpatrick can be seen living it up. At his son's football game, he's all smiles. But back in Detroit, it's estimated Kilpatrick stuck the city with a $15 million tab following his wake of political destruction, sex scandal, and whistleblower lawsuits filed against the city.
There is over $923,000 owed in restitution in this matter.
He agreed to pay the city $1 million in restitution, but now he claims he can only afford to pay Detroit $6 a month. But we tracked down Detroit's former mayor, living in 6,000 square feet of pure luxury. These are pictures from inside the million-dollar South Lake home he rents for $2,700 a month. Even his wife drives a candy red Escalade, rolling on custom 22s.
Declines to appear here Friday at 9 o'clock.
Now a Michigan judge doesn't buy Kilpatrick's claims that he's out of money, ordering him back to court.
I will have to contact him.
Well, I'm going to give you a date. It's not about his convenience. He's a defendant in a criminal case. So he doesn't get to tell me when he's going to be here.
After all, Kilpatrick acknowledges he makes $10,000 a month as a salesman for a software company in Addison. And still, he's only paid $14,000 of the $1 million owed to Detroit. The judge wanted at least $65,000 more by Friday morning. The Michigan Appeals Court put that on hold while it investigates Kilpatrick's claims of insufficient funds.
Unless a bunch of cash comes up pretty quickly, he's going to be back in jail.
Our repeated phone calls to both Kilpatrick's office and his attorney went unreturned. So we decided to pay a visit to his home.
Hey, sir, how are you?
Not only did we find Kilpatrick's father-in-law on the driveway.
You think I could ask you a couple questions?
No, absolutely not.
But we also found another shiny Escalade. That makes two of them.
It's almost as if he thumbs the nose at the system.
It all leaves prosecutors and the judge angry that Kwame Kilpatrick is living so large when he owes so much.